Hello students, I hope you are well equipped with your tables. Did you have fun and enjoy learning your tables with all the magical tricks that teacher gave you? Once I took my students to the farm and two of my boys were very much impressed in seeing the number of trees, and so they ran to find out how many trees were there in the farm. One of the boy kept counting the trees, 1, 2, 3, while the other one found out that there were 5 types of different trees arranged in rows of 10. So he used the idea of his tables and multiplied 5 different types of trees into 10, as there were 10 in a row, and he got the answer as 50. This was amazing when he came and told me that 5 into 10 gave him 50. So this is how he had multiplied, and this is multiplication that makes things very easy and fast. Today we are going to do multiplication. What is multiplication? Multiplication is combining each equal groups together to find a total. Adding a number over and over again is also called multiplication, like repeated addition. Now, the terms used in multiplication are groups, multipliers, tables, sets, and multiply. Now, there are 3 parts to our multiplication strategies. Now, for example, 4 into 3, you can see there is 4 into 3 and an equal sign, and you have 12. Now, the first number, 4, is a factor which is also called a multiplicand. Now, what is a multiplicand? The number 4 being a multiplicand in this equation, it is a number that is going to be multiplied. And number 3, the next factor, which is also called a multiplier, because with the number 3, the factor number 3, you are going to multiply number 4. This is an equal to sign. The answer in multiplication is called a product. The answer in multiplication is called the product. And here, the answer or the product is 12. So the concepts that we're going to cover up today are properties in multiplication and multiplication strategies. Let's take the first concept, properties of multiplication. When we multiply two numbers, the order in which we multiply them does not matter, because the product remains the same. The order may change, but the product remains the same. For example, 2 into 4. 2 fours are is giving you 8. And 4 twos are is also 8. For example, if I take 6 into 2 gives me 12. And 2 multiply by 6 also gives me 12. So what I have done exactly here is I just changed the order of the numbers, but my product, my answer remains the same. The second property is the product of a number and 1 is the number itself. It's the same number. For example, 3 multiplied by 1, we get 3. 3 ones are 3. And 9 multiplied by 1 is also 9. So what you see here is when you multiply a number by 1, you get the same number. Let's take a second example. If I multiply 4 into 1, that means 4 ones are is 4. And when I take 1 multiplied by 4 is also 4. So any number multiplied by 1 gives you the same number. Even if I take number 12 multiplied by 1, I will get the answer 12, because I multiplied the number with 1. The next property of multiplication is any number multiplied by a zero gives us zero. This is called the zero property of multiplication. For example, when you multiply 0 into 7 gives you 0. 7 into 0 also gives you 0. Let's take an example for the third property. The third property says, if I multiply, for example, if I take 11 multiplied by 0, it will give me a 0. If I multiply 0 into 11, I will again get a 0. So keep in mind that any number, whether it's 1 digit, 2 digit, or 3 or 4, it does not matter. But when you multiply any number with a 0, you get the value, the product, as 0. Let's go to the fourth property. The fourth property, when you multiply three numbers, grouping them, that means you are multiplying three numbers, there are three numbers at the spread, in any order, the product is always the same. Keep in mind, when you have three numbers to multiply, you multiply them in any order, the answer will be the same. For example, 3 into 4 into 5 gives you 12. 12 into 5 gives us 16. How did teacher do this? I have put bracket for two numbers. See, the 3 and 4 are together. And then I have multiplied it with 5. So when I multiply 3 by 3 into 4 gives me 12. And 12 multiplied by 5 gives me 60. Now let's group the other number. I have taken 3 and I have taken 5, which was outside the bracket. So 3 into 5, I made one group, and when I multiply by 4, I get 3 fives are is 15, and 15 multiplied by 4 gives me 60. Similarly, if I take 4 multiplied by 5 and then make a group and multiply by 3, I get 4 fives are 20 multiplied by 3, that gives me 60. Let's take an example. Say, for example, I have 2 multiplied by 3 multiplied by, say, I have 4. Now, this is the number and I have equal to sign. Now, I have to group, because the property says, when you multiply three numbers, grouping them in any order will give me the same value. So, say this is the number, three numbers that I've been given. And I need to find the answer. So what I'm going to do is, I will group 2 into 3. This becomes my one group. And I will multiply by 4, which will give me 2 threes are is 6. And 6 fours are is 24. Here, so I can also show you that I got the answer when I multiplied 2 into 3, I got 6, and I multiplied it with 4, that gave me 24. That gave me 24. Now I'm going to group the other two numbers. I can group 2 into 4 keeping 3 outside, and let me see what I get now. Now 2 fours are 8. So I write here 8 and I multiply by 3. So 8 threes are 24 again. Now I will have to take 4 into 3 and multiply by 2. Let's see what I get. 4 threes are 12. So I write here 12, I multiply with 2 and I get the answer. 12 twos are 24. Have you noticed that when I group them in any order, the grouping may be in any order, the answer that we get is the same. There is no change in the answer. You have grouped them in any order, but the answer is same. That means this is our fourth property. Now let's just go over all the property. Let's revise. The first property says, when we multiply two numbers, the order in which we multiply does not matter. The product will remain the same. In the second property, the product of a number multiplied by 1 is the number itself. The third property says any number multiplied by 0 gives you a 0, which is also called the 0 property. The fourth property says when you multiply 3 numbers, grouping them in any order, the value, the product, the answer will be the same. And this is how you see. We have done 2 examples and I hope you have followed the properties of multiplication. Our next concept is multiplication strategies. Now the first strategy we'll take is repeated addition. Now what is repeated addition? When you count and add over and over again the same number gives us an answer, and that the way we do that is called repeated addition. Now for example, I have given you 3 into 5. So we are going to do all the strategies using the concept as 3 into 5. 3 into 5 is actually 15. And how do we get that 15? We are going to drive it out in our different strategies. Now first one we are taking as repeated addition. Now since it is 3 to 5, the first factor 3, we're going to add 3 5 times. So 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3. Then group them. We have group 2 and we get 6. So 3 plus 3, another group, and I got another 6. And 3. So when we add 6 plus 6 gives us 12, and 12 plus 3 gives us 15. So we have come to the answer that 3 5 says 15. What we have done is we have added it in 3 plus 3 5 times. Now the same number 3 into 5 is 15, we take 5 plus 5 plus 5. We take the number 5 3 times. We took number 3 5 times. Now we are going to take number 5 3 times. So 5 plus 5 plus 5. Here we get, when we add 2 5's, we get a number 10. And when we add the number 1 that is here, the 5, when we add, we get 15. Because 10 plus 5 gives us 15. And so we conclude that 3 into 5 is 15, and when we add 5 times, we get 15, or we add 5 3 times, we also get 15. Alright, now we go to the next one. The next strategy is areas. Now, areas means an area is a group of objects arranged in rows or columns. They are arranged in rows and columns. An array is a group of objects arranged into rows and columns. Now I have 3 to 5. We're going to take the same number, 3 to 5, which gives us 50. So we're going to arrange make three rows having 5 columns. 1, 2, 3. We have taken 1, 2, 3. So we are getting 15. How do we get 15? Because in each column we have got 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. It has given us 15. All we have done is by putting it in rows and columns. We can do the same number in a different way by putting 5 in a row and making 5 columns. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And we have put 3 in each of those columns. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Did we not get the same answer? So it doesn't matter whether you put the numbers in the first factor in the column order or the row order. The answer, the value remains the same. So it is an array is a group of digits arranged in rows and columns. Our next strategy is drawing pictures. In fact, when we draw pictures, we visualize and we can understand easily. But don't draw pictures because this is not an art class, it is a maths class. So don't draw some detailed pictures where it's going to consume more time. We take something which is very easy. For example, since we have 3 into 5, I have made 5 circles because I've taken the factor 5, and in each circle I have put 3 dots. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. What I have done is I have 15 totally. So that means I have got 3 into 5, which has given me 50. In the next one, I have just made 3 circles, but I put 5 dots. 3 circles and I put 5 dots. And that has given me again 50. I'll take an example of this. Suppose I have 3 balloons. Say I have 3 balloons. And I am going to put, can anyone tell me how many dots can I put in my balloons or make such stars on my balloons? Since I have 3 balloons and I have given the factor 3 into 5. So I will need to put 5 stars in my balloons. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In another balloon, do I put 5? Yes, because we need to get, in each balloon we need to get 5. We need to group them in 5. So I write in the next balloon 5 stars. So I have 5 plus 5, which has given me 10, and 10 plus 5 gives me 50. So my third strategy, where I have to draw pictures, I have done balloons, here I have done circles, but the answer that I derived is the same. No matter what the picture is, but please see that the pictures are simple, easy to understand and easy to draw. We go to the next example. Skip counting. Skip counting is we leave numbers and we count our table. So let us take the table of 3 and 5 because we are given the number 3 into 5. Here what happens, 3 ones are 3 and 3 twos are 6. So we have skipped 3 digits. 3 threes are 9 and 3 fours are 12. 3 fives are 50. So I've circled the number 50 because that is the answer of 3 multiplied by 5. You get 50. Now in the 5 ones are 5 and 5 twos are 10. 5 threes is also 50. And I get 50. Let's take an example. Suppose I take 2 multiplied by 4. 2 multiplied by 4 will give me, let's find out what it will give me. So let's do 2 1s are 2. We're counting 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4, 2 3s are 6, 2 4s are 8. Now we have done skip counting with 2 digits. 2 plus 2 gives me 4, and 4 plus 2 gives me 6, and 6 plus 2 gives me 8. So the difference here, the skip counting that we have done, is with 2. The next factor here is 4. The next factor that we have here is 4. So, and the answer is 8. The factor is 4. So 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8. Here it is, 4 times we had to skip count because we multiplied by 2 multiplied by 4. But for 4, we had to multiply 2 times because it is 4 twos are 8. So we have just skipped 2 times. Here it's 4, here it's 2. And so the answer, 4, 2 fours are is 8. 2 fours are 8. 2 into 4, you get 8. And I hope you've understood what a skip counting is all about. Strategy is number line. Now to draw a number line, we take a scale, we draw a number line, a straight line. We mark the digits on the number line starting from a 0. Let's take, as 3 into 5 is given, let's take that. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. What we have done is we have done a number line, we have drawn a number line. And now we need to take that many jumps. Now here the number line that teacher has already done here is, we have taken from 0 to 15. Why has teacher done from 0 to 15 only? Because 3 into 5, 2 minutes can be put it on. Our fifth strategy is number line. Now first we draw a number line with numbers from 0 to 50, as we are given 3 into 5. Mark the numbers from 0 to 50, equal spacing, and then we require to jump because 3 into 5, we have to take 5 jumps of 3, taking 3 digits. So we take from, we go from 0, we go to 3, so 3 1s are 3, 3 2s are 6, 3 3s are 9, 3 4s are 12, 3 5s are 15. How many jumps did we take? 5. This is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 jumps. We can do another number line, but here we will take only 3 jumps because 5 threes is 50. So we'll take from 0 to 5. So 0, 5 ones are, so we take 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10, 5 threes are 50. So what are we doing is, we are going starting from here and we go to the number 15 because these are 3, 1, 2 and 3 jumps. What have we done? We have taken 3 jumps. The 3 numbers. Alright. Similarly, we do another example on the board. Using a ruler, you mark your numbers. Start from a 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Now what we do is, we have to give that many jumps because we have taken number 3 into 5. Let's take another number for an example. Other than that, suppose I take 3 into 2. 3 into 2. If I take 3 into 2, what will I get? 1s are 3. 3 twos are 6. Why have I taken only 2 jumps? Because 3 twos are 6. I have taken 3 numbers. But now if I have to do another number line with only, if I have to take number 2, that means I will take 2 jumps. 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4, 2 threes are 6. That means my green line is for the 2 times table, while my red line tells me the 3 times table. But when you do, you will have to do separate lines. So instead of doing that, you can draw another number line, right? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I take it 2 ones are 2, 2 threes are 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4, 2 threes are 6. So the value, what we get is the same. The answer to this is 6. This is just an example for you to understand better, but here is the example for 3 into 5. Next, we'll take block towers, vertical lines and horizontal lines. Here, for the block towers, 3 into 5, so teacher has done 3 blocks, 1, 2 and 3, and divided them into 5. After drawing the blocks, I have divided them into 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Now the similar blocks, I have taken 5 blocks here instead of 3, but I have divided them into 3. That means I have taken 5 blocks, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and divided them into 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. And I get the answer 15. That means whichever form I try to do, I will get the same value. And what is the value? 50. We have done repeated addition, we have done areas, we have done drawing pictures, we have done skip counting, we have done number line, we have done block towers. We have another intersection that we haven't done. Let's do the intersection. What we have to do for intersection is we draw lines like this. Alright, I have taken three vertical lines. 1, 2 and 3. These are vertical lines. And I am going to draw 5 horizontal lines. What has teacher done? She has taken 3 vertical lines and I've done 5 vertical lines. Now, since it is, the concept is intersection, when one vertical line and a horizontal line meet, we get a point. And how many points we will get? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. What was the answer? 15. 3, 5, is 15. I have only drawn 3 vertical lines with 5 horizontal lines, and at the point of intersection, I have counted how many points of intersections are there, and what we get is 15. We do the other way around, do the opposite. We are going to make 5 lines, 5 vertical lines, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, and draw 3 horizontal lines, 1, 2 and 3. Here, let's count how many points of intersection we get. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So, have you understood how to get the answer, to derive the answer in so many ways? We had 7 different ways which we derived the answer. Let's do an example of block towers. Example 7. Now for block towers, let's take a number. We will make a block like this. They are actually like the train. That's how you have for the train the tracks. So we will make actually tracks. So 1, 2 and we will take 3 tracks. Now there are 3 tracks which we are going to divide them into 5 each. So why are we going to divide them in 5 each? Because we are given 3 into 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So when we count, 5 plus 5 plus 5 gives us 50. Similarly, we will have to have 5 blocks . So how many blocks do you have now? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But here, you will have to divide them with you. Are you supposed to divide them with 5 or 3? 5 or 3? No, you are supposed to divide them with only 3. Because you have 5 rows already, dividing them into 3. And what do we get? 3 + 3 + 3 + 3 + 3, that is 5 threes are 15. Hope this is really going to help you to understand and learn the multiplication strategies so that you can use them in your work. I also don't want to pressurize you, but I want to make sure that you are just not memorizing the multiplication facts, but understanding the concepts of multiplicational ideas. I hope you had a good time. You had fun learning multiplication. For now, bye.